Hello, my dear students. I welcome you all to my class of English Standard 7th. In the last video, we have seen activity 5 and 6. And I told you to write 10 symbols of India and what is your favorite symbol and what it stands for. I hope you have done this homework. Now, activity 7. Activity 7 is a group activity. It is a class activity. That which symbol is your group's favorite symbol? Since we are not in the group, we are not in the class, we will go ahead. Dear students, we will see now activity 8. Just as poems have symbols and India has symbols, stories often have symbols too. Many stories use animals as symbols. For example, many stories use the lion as a symbol of royalty. How many times have you heard that a lion is a king? Different people can give the same symbol different meanings. For some people, cats symbolize long life, but other people might say black cats symbolize bad luck. In many parts of India, the cow is a symbol of many things for many people. Dear students, in the last poem of Rabindranath Tagore, we have seen that a stream is a symbol for reason. And India also have different symbols like our national tree, the banyan tree, national song, Vande Mataram. So same as stories also have symbols. Many stories use animals as symbols. For example, you have heard the lion is a symbol of royalty. Many stories we have also heard that the lion is considered as a king. So, lion is a symbol for royalty, for pride, etc. And different people give same symbol but different meaning. Like lion is used for pride. Some people consider lion as a royalty. Some may consider lion as a strength and agility. For example, cat. Cat symbolizes long life for some people. But for other people, black cat stands for bad luck. Some people think that black cats brings bad luck. In many parts of India also, cow is considered as a mother. Means cow symbolizes motherhood. So, many animals symbolizes something in the story. Like lion as a royalty, as a pride. Cat symbolizes long life or it can brings bad luck. Cow symbolizes as a mother. So, in the stories also, animals symbolizes something. So, my dear students, here we will read one story and think about what these animals in the story might be symbol of. This is the story, The Fox and the Rabbit. So, my dear students, here we will read out the story and we will find out that which animals in this story symbolizes for what. There was once a very clever fox who loved to brag of his cleverness. One day he said to the rabbit, "I am so clever," he said, "that I know 100 ways to escape enemies." "Wow," the rabbit said, "I have only one, but it works well." So, dear students, in this story, the clever fox who always bragged, means he always boasting, proudly speaking about his cleverness. One day, this fox said to the rabbit that I am so clever and I know 100 ways to run away, to escape from the enemies, from the hunters. The rabbit said, "Wow. But I have only one way. I know only one way to run away, to hide from the hunters. But it works very well. The fox said, "You should listen to me. I will teach you many, many more. You should know many ways to escape like I do." But the fox said to the rabbit that you have to listen to me and I will teach you many, many more, 100 ways to run away from the hunters, and you should also use the way I do. Just at that moment, the fox and the rabbit heard the cry of a pack of hunters coming towards them. When they both were talking to each other, they heard that the cry of a pack of hunters, the sound of a pack of hunters, means group of hunters, were coming towards them. Immediately, the rabbit leaped down his hole and was gone. He called back to the fox, "This is my plan. What are you going to do?" And as the rabbit heard the group of hunters coming towards them, immediately the rabbit jumped into his hole and he hid himself. And he called to the fox that, "This is my plan. This is my one way to escape from the hunter. What are you going to do? How are you hiding yourself from the hunters?" The fox thought first of one way, then another. Then he thought of a better way. Then he considered another way. And while he was thinking of all his clever choices, the hunter caught him up and he was soon carried off. And as the fox nature, he was having the 100 ways to run away. He thought of the first way. Then he thought of the another way. Then he thought of the better way. He was thinking about something more better way. And in that thinking and thinking of his clever choices, he was caught by the hunters. And very soon, he was taken away by the hunters. So, my dear students, in this story, we have seen the two animals, the fox and the rabbit. They stand for something. We know, dear students, the fox is a symbol of cleverness. But here in the story, because of his boasting nature, his bragging nature, he was caught by the hunters. And we know the rabbit is not a fast running animal. But then also, because of his quickness, he try to hide himself from the hunters. And here in the story, the rabbit is symbol of smartness, quickness. So here in the story, we can come to know the different symbols about different animals. So here, my dear students, we will end this session. Now it's your homework time. Your homework is, you have to read this story again and you have to find out the hard words. You have to underline the hard words and you have to find out the meaning of that hard words from the dictionary, or you can use the internet. You have to note down these hard words into your fair note books. So, my dear students, here we will end. Thank you very much.